because it's Tuesday, and we're going to fill the studio with so much love and music and stardom. We have two incredible, incredible artists. So joining us as we cook up a storm today, we have not only one, but two celebrity guests on our Tuesday cook-along. The vivacious Moonchild Sanelly and the one and only Zulu Mkhathini. Woohoo! And they have done again, obviously they're just killing it, but they've done another fresh collaboration on a new single titled Shikisha. And in true Afternoon Express style, the duo will also be giving us an exclusive performance of the new track. But first, let's catch up on a compilation of some of their amazing music. Online if you've got any questions for our superstars by using the hashtag Afternoon Express in your comments. Welcome, guys.
Thank you for having us.
I'm so excited to have you here. I've literally been waiting a whole year to see you again.
Yeah.
I've been waiting forever to see you again.
And we've got a bone to pick.
Tell me.
It's been a year and you still say my surname wrong.
Tell me. Oh. I said it correctly yesterday. You wouldn't believe it.
You said Mkhathini.
Did I say Mkhathini?
Mkhathini.
Mkhathini.
Yes, perfect.
You know, I said it correctly yesterday.
Oh, man, I missed it.
But I was just thinking, what kind of a maka are you? Okay, so the two of you have literally had, like, the best year ever.
Thank
basically, you.
You
guys both own the world, and we just live in it.
True.
So how did this collaboration come about?
Oh, man. It's very, very simple. Like, Moon and I started working from Iwoke Para. We then, from there, just, like, our energy just connected, you know?
Amazing.
So we started calling each other Energy Wife.
Hobby.
And Energy Hobby.
Hey, hey, hey.
We are the energies.
Yeah.
So then after a while, I was working on my project. I'm like, Moon, we need to work on a song.
Yeah.
She's like, no worries, call me up.
Yeah.
She came through. I played the song for her as a reference just to say, this is what I'm thinking. By the end of the song, she's like, okay, hubby, put me on. I'm ready to record my verse. And I was like, okay, then we have it. We have Shikisha.
So this Shikisha's going onto your new album.
Yes.
Which I believe is just going to be so incredible because it's completely genre free.
Yes.
Nowadays, everyone's like gender fluid, but now yours is genre fluid.
Yeah, nice. Man, I think with the background and the music that we make as well, you finally realize that there's no more time for being R&B or hip hop or quiet.
Yeah, I agree with
because
you.
Because everybody. Be bored. Yeah. It's like you're calling it freedom and you're expressing, but you're stuck in a box.
True.
That's just like, doesn't make sense to me. I think I'd lose my mind if
I had to finish each other's sentences.
No, of course. It's like wearing a similar outfit every day.
Dude, how do you do that?
No, I don't.
You can't.
And I heard that you were just blown away with Moonchild because of the speed at which you can write it. I mean, what is your process? I mean, he's obviously very inspiring, just that voice.
No, my biggest thing is when I get in, I don't know, I just think of something. If I think of a word, I can think of a whole scenario.
Yeah.
And I always talk, I'm always like joking and talking rubbish, like with the truth.
Yeah.
So it was easy. I don't know. I think because I'm always writing music, I just like come in and I think of a word. If you don't have a narrative already, then I'll just come up with whatever I think.
Yeah.
But then he already had that. And so my biggest thing was like, you're not picking me up, actually. I'm about to change these rules. So I trapped you. I'm the one who danced for you to come. And it was a trap, but you don't know yet. So I'll let you think you won. Meanwhile, I had my own targets.
Yeah.
And dancing she did. Mm-hmm. Now, I've just, like, because I'm wearing such a beautiful dress, I can't actually, like, leopard crawl across the ground like I want to do. Mm-hmm. How did your, the past year, the reason why you haven't come to see me is because you've been collaborating with Beyonce.
Oh, that chick.
My girl.
How on earth did that happen?
That was crazy. We started working on the project like last year. And it was, you know, when she used Wokepada for her Global Citizen Africa situation. Yeah. So at that time, I'd already been working with her eyes. So her eyes was doing research for a project that was coming. So what I didn't know what the project was for, I knew who it was for. So I knew I was sending melodies for Beyonce. I knew I was writing hooks for Beyonce. I knew because the main thing, she wanted inspiration, like direct inspiration, the things that we actually say. So I was like her closer thing this side, this side for, with the melodies and stuff. I even got to do like the Pharrell backups. I did like so many backups. I didn't even know which songs were gonna make it into the project. And it was nice because it was like my own secret and I didn't tell anyone. This is before the non-disclosure. So it was like pretty, pretty awesome.
I mean, that is huge. So what is the agreement? You are her South African voice, basically. So you've got to come up with her
project,
melodies and Okay.
For now, because I mean there's a whole lot to do. Mm. The press girl. I've never been in studio for, like, I write so quick, but I had to change four lines. I had to do studio sessions, like, four nights in a row. For those four lines, to a point where I was just like, you know what, I'm just going to give you everything.
Yeah.
So I just started giving her, like, everything. Then I started getting songs from the album.
Okay, but now are you, and I mean, it's so taboo to talk about money, but are you getting mechanical royalties? And
like,
are you smelling the dollars?
You've got to secure the bag.
Absolutely. I am
shame. Oh,
I couldn't be pleased.
She
me.
This is incredible.
I said it's freaking crazy, right?
So yeah, I haven't actually met her yet, but I mean, are you WhatsApp friends?
No, but I've seen her watch my story once.
Like, oh my God, you watch your story?
People who watch stories are my stalker ex-boyfriends. You've got Madonna, Beyonce.
I mean, she's coming. Madonna's definitely coming.
Madonna's coming.
She's definitely coming. Yeah. Like, America's coming. Because I'm songwriting for a lot of people.
Who else are you songwriting?
Look, did you see how she name-dropped? She name-dropped everybody like they were friends. Yeah, then it was Pharrell, then it was Beyonce.
I'm just writing for a lot of people. There's this artist, Cleo, who's got like 10 million followers. She's an actress in Brazil. Her team also contacted for a song while I was in America.
Yeah.
I'm definitely writing stuff when Diplo sends me. I'm definitely writing. Jidenna now I'm writing for my album because I'm a part of his album.
Yeah.
And then...
He just dropped or he's dropping now, right?
He's dropping the album. Okay. Yeah, so even there with the ideas and...
So you just... You're coming for everyone, basically.
Everything.
Next thing you're going to tell me is that you kissed Diplo.
That's not what I'm trying to hear.
No, I didn't say anything. I'm like, but I wouldn't say yes if it was yes. So I think it's safer to say no comment.
Okay.
No shame. No. No, I didn't.
No, really, guys, no.
I worked so hard. You know, sometimes people end up losing respect for what you need to be delivering.
Yeah.
Because the thing is, everybody's hot. So what you going to do? Are you going to sleep with everyone for your product? You need to focus on your product.
No. We're not.
Because you are going to, you're bound to bump into hot people all the time. And you're not going to have all of them.
We do
you
love
can have some of them if you
the
want.
Time.
But I mean.
So now you also, busiest year ever, mm-hmm. album. Fashion, what's happening on the fashion front?
Well, I'm always wearing my own clothes.
I mean, but can I tell you, when you walked in, we have to get a full view of this.
Sure.
I mean, let's just have a look at this outfit. Tell us what you're wearing. You need to come here on a Fashion Express Thursday just to showcase
your gear.
Well,
man, I'm wearing Zulovsky, you know. There's a brand that I've got. It's called Zulovsky. We are launching next year, so we've been in the process of developing it for a minute now. Because we're trying to just create the first... proper African luxury brand that can really compete.
You know you're not leaving here with those pants. I'll give you a pair of my jeans.
Am I taking the shirt home?
No, I want the shirt as well. But I don't know if the shirt's going to fit me.
Cleavage, girl.
I know, but I'll just leave that button.
Yeah, so it's Zulovsky, and basically what we're trying to do is change the narrative of like African couture and luxury brands and really do premium. Because, you know, we've got this mindset where we believe that what's South African is not premium or what's African is not premium. Yeah. We can't compete on a global platform.
Yeah.
And for me, it's like, no, man, watch the clothes, man. These clothes are just as hard, if not harder.
Can I tell you what is premium? So I go to sleep every night to like a guided meditation, and it's a somebody's voice speaking me through my bed. Can't you like record those so that I can just listen to your voice? I go to sleep like, oh. Welcome. So thank you so much for being here.
Thanks for having us.
We are going to have so much fun today because I know he's cooking. The chef. And
I don't I'm a wack. Like, my chef is Uber Eats.
Oh, really? Yeah. Okay, well, my chef is, my new chef is here. And I've got the good chefs there. So now we've asked you if you've got any questions for our superstars. And Chadwick Holtman asked, hashtag Afternoon Express, what inspired you to do the song together? I think you've kind of answered that.
Okay,
but what inspired?
But I can tell you the song itself. I know in my head it was going to come out around Women's Month, you know? And the conversation that was happening in studio, we were talking about how women are like oppressed, or women are judged whenever they feel provocative or sexy, or if they make the first move, you know? So we started making a song where we were just saying, guys, let women Shikisha and be proud of it, you know? Yeah. And let them dance without being criticized. Then Moonchild comes along and she takes it to a high level because she's very confident at being, you know, sexy and just well aware of who she is, and she doesn't really mind what people think.
I want a rope around me so that I can Shikisha.
I can get you a roping lesson, actually. Because
yes,
the shoots I do with the roping, I do them in Cape Town.
I'm coming to that next shoot that you're doing with the roping, and I'm going to
Can I come watch? Can I just come watch? I just want to come watch the roping.
Then Busiswa Kulwane said, I just want to say hi, Pambili Mkhathini Moonchild Sanelly. There you go. You both rock, and I can't wait for you to shake that kitchen. I'm so excited for your coming to my favorite show ever.
Sure.
We love having them here. Okay, so it's definitely going to be a collaborative effort in the kitchen after the break as we put Moonchild and Zulu Mkhathini's cooking skills to the test. They will be helping us prepare a really, really tasty lamb rogan josh with Chef Labumbu.